So, you've probably heard of an application called Fyxer. Now, this is an email AI assistant that wants to help you to take the weight out of your email. And you're probably looking at adverts or seeing it in a lot of different places and wondering what it is and actually what it can bring to value to your life. So this video today is sponsored by Zapier. If you're interested, they are the AI automation leaders. You can find them linked below and a little bit more about them later in this video. So today I'm gonna overview Fyxer because I've played with it and I've got some opinions, but I'm gonna be sharing them later on in this video and giving you an overview of what it is and how it works. So very simply, Fyxer is spelt a little bit strangely. I'll put it on screen now, but it's an AI assistant and it wants to do a couple of things for you. And I would say it does three things. It categorizes your email for you. Then what it does is it helps create drafts, so it saves you time using your voice, as well as bringing in things like a calendar, so it helps you to plan a little bit like Calendly, and also has an AI meeting assistant, which will help you to transcribe your notes and send them to people on from that meeting. So it does a couple of things really well. It connects with Gmail and Outlook, and apparently they have 40,000 businesses or individuals using it right now. So what and how does it do that? Well, essentially it connects with Gmail or Outlook and learns how you speak in your emails using sample emails, and then it basically translates that into auto drafts for you. Now this drafting feature is very clever and is what we've seen in apps like Shortwave, Superhuman, and many more over the last couple of years. So before we move on in explaining what it does and what it sort of how it operates is, I want to talk about the pricing. Now pricing for this application is relatively steep. The app is priced with a standard and a pro pricing. The standard pricing is, or the basic, they call it, $30 per user per month. And that gives you access to only one account, as well as one calendar, which is a little limiting if you have multiple accounts. But there is a $50 a month option, which gives you access to pretty much everything. Now, this wants to be an all-in-one tool. So it's trying to replace a few things here, like Fireflies, Calendly, and a couple of other alternatives. But all in all, those pricings are a lot cheaper with the annual pricing, but at the same time, still not cheap as an overall experience. So now I've reviewed another one called Jace. I'll probably do a comparison video. This one doesn't come with a Chrome extension. You literally go into a portal, plug in your Gmail or Outlook, and you're pretty much in your application. Now you can start to modify how your emails are categorized first. So this is a very helpful resource that appears on the left-hand side in your Gmail and essentially allows you to organize things based on whether you're responding to them or whether they're marketing, etc., or just FYI emails. This is a neat way to organize your email and inbox and is just a helpful way to structure it versus what Gmail traditionally do with their labels or their little sort of categorization at the top. Now, what's really nice as well is the application does allow you to certain emails, port them into the application, but you can't auto label or choose a new label from that, which is a bit of a shame. So I was looking at the certifications and they do have a few certifications on the website. So do make sure it's compliant and security happy for you, whether you're using it as an individual or as a company. I'll include the link to that below. So I played around with the categorization. It worked fairly well. The application was able to organize stuff in the background for me. I was using Jace at the same time, but it was still able to do that pretty efficiently, which was pretty good. Now this is a helpful experience and the auto drafting function essentially goes into those emails and it essentially replies or prepares a reply for you. So it can also include their Calendly-like link, which helps you to book meetings. This is a really helpful feature because if the email has reference to any point, the like a date being in mind, you can bring in your suggested scheduler and then it will book the meeting for you, which is a very helpful experience. Did you know that over 1.3 million people use Zapier with AI? This can help you save time, optimize repetitive tasks, and get more done. Zapier helps you to create workflows and automation by building simple or complex workflows and connecting nearly 8,000 integrations. Zapier is one of the leaders in AI automation, and that's why over 3.4 million companies use Zapier to get things done. Get started today for free down in the link in the description. So one of the things you can do is in the portal, you can actually narrow down what your typical draft replies look like, which will allow you to add custom instructions, which I haven't seen in many other applications. You also have the ability to see follow-ups as well, so you can get follow-up reminders on emails that have not been replied to yet. And you can also start the scheduling breakdown. So for example, you can narrow stuff down on what availability you have for that meeting scheduler. Now, the only negative thing is you can't really fully customize the scheduling link function, which isn't what you get in comparison with the likes of Calendly. Calendly is much more extensive than this, but at the same time, it'll probably do you good if you have a pretty generic schedule. Now, the AI meeting scheduler connects with Google Meet, Zoom, and Microsoft Teams, and essentially, it can automatically join meetings. So just be aware of that before you set things up. You can also add in a bunch of custom words and terminologies as well, which is a helpful dictionary of things that commonly come up in meetings, but get worded in the wrong way so that the transcription pulls the right information. So you can, in the pro version, connect up the likes of a CRM, which is HubSpot CRM, which you can find as part of that, as well as Zoom, and any other preferences can be created from this area. So one of the things you can do with all of the meetings is, once they're created in the AI form, the transcription, is you can actually chat with those meeting nights, which is another helpful additional feature. So they're trying to replace a few different things here. They're trying to replace a traditional email AI, an organizer like Sanebox, and AI meeting summarizers. Now, typically you pay for that type of thing in three separate applications, and they're probably round out to about $20 to $25 to $30 per month. So if you're an individual, it sort of condenses everything into one house. Probably doesn't do it as customized as what I see in other applications, but at the same time, does a relatively good job of putting it together quite well. The application also works with Gmail, so you sort of feel comfortable getting straight in there. So this application is priced at $30 for the basic plan, but there is naturally a lot cheaper pricing when you go to the annual plan. I believe the annual plan was $270 for the basic plan, and I'll include the pro pricing on screen too for the annual pricing as well. So what was my opinion of Fyxer? To be honest, these applications are a little bit interesting to me. I don't really see them in full fruition. I feel like they are almost incredibly well marketed towards people that don't know that options like Shortwave or Superhuman already exist out there on the market. So whilst I think they're incredibly helpful and will get a lot better over time, I don't really see how they're not just ChatGPT wrappers plugged into Gmail extensions right now. I think the future is incredibly bright. There's a lot of funding and great minds behind both of the applications that I've reviewed recently, both Jace and the likes of Fyxer. But at the same time, I think it's still early days. Overall, I'm actually more impressed by Fyxer than I am with Jace AI. Fyxer didn't have its own application, Jace had its own application, but I feel like the overall package and offering in terms of pricing was a lot better value than I see against apps like Jace. So if you're interested in my full comparison between Jace and Fyxer, you can subscribe below. You can find these applications below if you're interested, and thank you so much for stopping by in today's video. Again, if you're looking for AI tools or resources, jump over to toolfinder.co, and thanks to Zapier for sponsoring this video.